You mentioned about CV. CV can be an important factor for your selection. Mm. So can we break down the CV, how many pages we should write, what content should be there?
Okay, so like since we are in PhD, so we should try to constrain to at least maximum 2 pages.
Maximum two pages.
Mm.
And minimum, which will, how much can go? One page?
Minimum one page. Yes.
1 to 2 pages.
Yes,
okay,
yeah.
Great.
Don't exceed more than 3 to 4 pages because it's too much where you have put in everything, which is not required.
And the professor might not be having time to read
all that.
If you are writing in flowery language.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So, basically include like first few lines, tell about what you're very good at. So, give an introduction of what kind of a person, what are your passions and why do you fit into particular sectors of your field. Give a few lines like bulletin points, 5 to 6 points saying about yourself. Then follows your education, wherein you will say about the latest education, followed by the not all your 10th standard, 12th standard. Then it's better to stick till BSc. Or your BTech or whatever the bachelor's. Bachelor's, masters and PhD or bachelor's. Some people would have got like from bachelor's to direct PhD, so just had them.
Okay.
And if you have got any projects, particularly in BTech, MTech, put those projects under that. And if those supervisors are willing to refer you, add them also there, so that you work under this particular professor. So when you should add a references at the end of your CV. So the same people can be there, so that it will be easy for the professor to reach out to them. Okay, so after education, if before education, if you have had in any industry, you should have worked for a year or some teaching, whatever you have done in between, you just try to add that also.
Okay.
After that, you have your education, and if you have any, if you have got any travel fellowship awards, like sandwich programs, that you add it in the next section, and followed by if you have any publications where you would have published some in journals, try to mention like if you're the first author or you're the co-author, because having a co-author picture also tells you that how good are you as a team member. You have a good collaborative skills.
Okay, so that is not disadvantage.
That's not a disadvantage. Certainly, it is a good one because it will show. You are not independently working on your own, but you are able to talk with some person, work with him. So you have a good communication and supervising skills or whatever. Like you have the collaborative skills.
So don't hesitate if you have some third author, fourth author.
Nothing. Yes.
Okay.
If you have contributed to that paper, it is always an addition to your CV.
Great.
So, followed by a publication, you would have attended some great big workshops, summer schools, winter schools, and also like poster presentation, oral presentation. So, pick up your the best 5, 6, like not, if you have done like some 10, 15, don't add all 10, 15, but choose the best 5 or 6 and put them.
Okay.
And followed by, it will be a referees, so at least 3 referees you would ask. One will be your PhD supervisor. Most of them, it is necessary. Only some people don't look for that supervisor because some will have a different experience and they don't want to give their PhD supervisor. So it depends. So at least 3 referees.
What do referees do? Like, what is the work here?
Referees, like, see, if you are approaching the new professor, they don't know in and out of you.
Yeah.
So how do you basically work? Are you really interested? Are you approaching? What's your motto? What's your goal? What's your aim? So those things are usually understood by your PI, right? Like your PhD supervisor. He knows you better than any other person. So I think some academic referees will add an important point to your CV, I think. Because any postdoc application you apply, they will ask for at least 1 or 2 references for sure. So you need someone who know you very well. Like, how good are you at your academics? How are you at your different skills? What are the skills you have acquired? So those things matters a lot actually. So this is like the old outline of CV. So you need to have your self-introduction a bit. followed by education background, and if you have any like research activities apart from your PhD and things that you have done for a year okay. or two, add that, followed by any kind of awards, the fellowships you have been got, then followed by your publications, conferences, and references. That's all. It has to fit into two pages. That will be good.
Yeah, perfectly explained. Yes.